Poor old Mr. Rochester. Oh, you're looking pretty. This guy here, this almond dipper, he's got a bit of an appetite. And the problem that we've got is that he, well, all of the ones here, although most of them, well, they're all on fake or dead eggs because of the time of year. So like half of them come out infertile. But these guys, whoa, hello pretty. Hello pretty. You're escaping that rapist, are you? You're a pretty little lady, aren't you? Hey? Do you want to get on there? How's that, dear? Is that nice? Whoa. Anyway, this here is Mr. Rochester's food. Because what Mr. Rochester does is he... Well, what he does is he will... all of the people in the apartment, all of the people in the breeding boxes, all the little guys, will get given a portion of food. Because a lot of them don't come out at all. But what he does very cunningly is he will get given his portion of food, start eating it, and in a second he sees the other food out, the rest of the pigeons, he'll run out there and scoff as much as he can and try and eat three or four portions worth. And so he gets that, and then he comes back and scoffs on this all night long. Which is fine for him, but his poor wife, well, she actually gets some, but like, she only gets what's in here. Well, half of it, because he's eating half of it, plus everyone else's food. I know, doesn't it look shocking? Isn't it shocking? So, anyhow, I'm going to have to change this arrangement somehow. Really, they shouldn't be on nests. I've just left them there because they're happy there, and there aren't really enough perches at the moment, so... I think really I need to make perches and close these boxes off or take their nests away or something. But anyway. Thank you. Hello. You gonna come and have some food? You're gonna try and dig your ear then, right? See if you'll follow. Come on, you need to practice. Come on. Come on, you need to learn to follow the cam. Come on, guys. Yeah, you're starting to get the idea. Let's come and run it out here. But any of you that are hungry are going to have to come out here. Hello, lads. Here you are. You getting the idea yet? Right. What will you think once I put this down here and start filling it with food again, huh? Yeah, are you going to get the idea then? Because if you don't get it, someone... Whoever does get the idea will be getting all the food. So, I'll start getting the idea pretty soon, guys. Okay. Right. I don't think we're going to need all of them today, because I don't think you're all going to come out here, are you? Which is fine. Come on. What's going on down here, guys? You can have your food down here. Oh, look at you. Hello. Hello. Are you going to go and have some cheese? I know you don't like eating on the floor, but if you want food, that's where you're going to have to go. You're going to get used to having to follow this. You can come down here. Just staring at the sea. Like they don't believe that they're there. Oh, hello. Hello, dear. That was quite a dark, isn't it? Oh, you funny one. It's like she flew into the window and it posted her down and out. I don't think she expected to fly outside. there. Leaked the seed, random stray seeds in there. But not that, yeah. All right. Work out the windows and how sometimes they can get through them when I push them through. They know how to get in and out of the hole, but they're very intrigued by the windows. Look at that pretty neck.
Come on, dear.
Would you like to go inside? Look.
Hello.
She wasn't too impressed about that, was she? Yeah. Thank you.